So the patient has presented with diplopia. How will you proceed? Loud, please.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Dr.
Okay, the patient is complaining of diplopia. So how will you do a diplopia charting?
So now we'll check the ask him whether he sees the target double in or the
ask him.
Sir, आपको ये दो दो नजर आए आपको मुझे बताना है, ठीक है? Sir, first I will check whether it's unioculary or binocular. ये आंकड़ दीजिए. एक नजर आ रहा है कि दो? दूसरा आंकड़ दीजिए. एक है. अब आपको
okay, so first you have seen whether the diplopia is uniocular or binocular, good. But then next question should be whether there is vertical diplopia or horizontal diplopia. So what do you ask? The two images are lying side by side, horizontally or vertically, so that you can check appropriately. So ask him.
इसके साथ दूसरा नजर आ रहा है वो सीधा लेटा हुआ है या सीधा है? सीधा है. इस तरफ को है या इस तरफ को है? अब आप मुझे ये बता रहे हैं कि
नो, यू सी वर्टिकल और हॉरिजॉन्टल मींस द टू इमेजेस आर लाइंग साइड बाय साइड और वन इज लाइंग अबव द अदर. See, if there is vertical diplopia, then the patient will say the one is down and one is up. If there is horizontal diplopia, the patient will say the two are lying side by side. So what is the difference? How will you proceed differently in vertical or horizontal diplopia?
Sir, vertical
diplopias
are mostly when
No, the point is that in checking horizontal diplopia, you will keep the target like this, so that the two images are parallel. If in case of vertical diplopia, you will hold the target like this, so that the two targets are above and down. Okay, so the first you have decided that it is, let's say, vertical or horizontal, and you will hold the target accordingly. For horizontal like this, for vertical like this. So the next question is, in which gaze the diplopia is more? The patient said in left gaze it is more, right? Let's say in right gaze it is not present. So in left gaze, when the diplopia is more, you ask the patient to close one eye. You close the right eye. And you ask the patient which of the two have disappeared. The patient will say, let's say the farther image has disappeared. So the farther image, the image which is away from the patient, belongs to the diseased eye, abnormal eye. So if on covering the right eye, the left one has disappeared, it means the right eye is having peritic muscle. So you ask one thing that which image has disappeared and in which gaze there is maximum separation of the two images. Let's say diplopia is present in the right gaze also and in the left gaze also. But in the left gaze, the distance between the two images is more, it means the paritic muscle is in, this is the direction of action of the paritic muscle. Okay. So in case of vertical diplopia, when you hold the target like this, you ask an additional question, whether the two images are parallel to each other or panegyric. Oh. So are they parallel with each other or are they having an angle with each other? So if there is an angle, it means there is an element of torsion, intorsion or extorsion. So you ask the patient in which position the two images are maximally separated. Like let's say the patient says that in this direction these are maximally separated. At right angle, maybe the torsional element is more. The patient will say, now the angle is more in this direction. So there are two questions in vertical squint. One is separation and one is angle. So you want to see what is the primary action, what is the position in which the primary action is present. Let's say in the left superior oblique palsy, the two images will be maximally separated in this position, in the left superior oblique palsy, acting in adduction, the maximum separation will be like this. But the maximum separation will be at 90 degrees, right? So you have to see which position there is maximum separation of the images and at which position you ask the patient to hold the other. Let's say target and describe. So what is the position of the other image? So this is one image. If you look at this one, so hold the pen like how you are looking at the other image. So the patient will describe the images like this, or images like this, or images like this. So accordingly you make a chart on the paper. So any paper, how will you make a chart? So in this patient, let's say there is maximal separation in the left gaze. So how will you make a chart? So this is the case of horizontal diplopia, and the patient is having maximum horizontal diplopia. So you are making lines according to the vertical diplopia. In horizontal diplopia, you make vertical lines and horizontally separate them in the direction of the gaze. So the patient is having in the left gaze, okay. Though there was no diplopia in the right gaze. So there was single image in the right gaze, and in the left gaze there is horizontal diplopia. Horizontal diplopia usually does not have a torsional component. So the two lines are parallel, only the distance between the two varies. And you know which is the muscle at fault. Now coming above, so this is the vertical diplopia. In vertical diplopia, you want to see the position at which the maximum separation of the two images occur. Let's say it is here in the abducted position, the maximum separation. And at right angle, there will be maximum angle between the two. So these are the two points you want to ask on checking the diplopia. So the first question is, which image disappears on covering one eye? The second is, which is the position in which there is maximum separation of the two images? Okay.